Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair Life. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video to any of you having a Hyundai Tucson. If you guys have a Hyundai Tucson and you have air bubbles in the cooling system, in the reservoir, the coolant tank, stay with us, we'll explain what can cause that. One of those could be something super simple, but if you don't fix it on time, you may end up needing a new engine. So stay with us and we'll explain what it is. All that will be covered in this video today. It should work on multiple generation, years and models Hyundai Tucson. It doesn't matter if you have gasoline or diesel engine. Before we start, let me tell you a little bit about us. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do that? Simply because our mission at the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need, guys, in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep providing this free information to you. Now, if you guys need to buy tools, parts, and you want to save quite a bit of money, get them for a really good price and quick shipping, check out the link in the description of the video below. That's where we get all our supplies and tools from. So, what can cause bubbles in the cooling system? Now, we're going to start with something that you hope it never happens, and we'll explain towards the end about something that could be really minor, but if you don't take care of it, okay, it can easily, okay, lead to needing the engine rebuild or the engine replaced. So let's say you drive the car for a while, it gets hot, okay, in the coolant tank, okay, you start having bubbles, you have pressure in the radiator hose, because those bubbles will build pressure in the radiator hose. From here it will transfer to the coolant tank. So what can cause that now? Okay, number one thing that usually happens, guys, it's a failing head gasket. Head gasket that failed can easily do that. Why? Because, okay, let's explain now, okay, what we have specifically here. This is, guys, the head gasket, okay, right there. This is, okay, let me put it this way. This is the head gasket, you can see. It's between the cylinder block and the cylinder head. The purpose of that gasket is to keep the compression inside the cylinders, not to spread out to the coolant chamber and the oil chamber as well. So, what happens now, guys, okay, if that gasket fails right here, okay, anywhere on the cylinder, on each of the cylinders, it will start pumping hot air and it will make its way in the coolant system. From there, it will try to find the highest point and the water pump will spread it all the way to the radiator and it will go to the coolant tank. So, that hot air actually, guys, will make your car to overheat as well. When you usually have bubbles in the coolant tank, sooner or later you will develop overheating issues as well. Now, if you want to see how to replace the head gasket, okay, we have the special video on the channel that teaches you how to replace head gasket on Hyundai Tucson and what you need to do, okay, because most people don't do it correctly, how to clean the engine block and the cylinder head when you replace head gaskets. We have a special video that explains that on our main YouTube channel, Auto Repair Guys, how to clean cylinder block and head gasket for head gasket replacement. Number two, guys, something that most people never think of. Okay, let's say you replaced water pump or radiator or thermostat. You had to drain your coolant. Anytime you drain your coolant, guys, okay, you need to do certain procedure. Most people will drain the coolant, they'll add coolant and start driving, and then they start eventually overheating their car. Why? Because you need to bleed the cooling system. If you don't bleed the cooling system, what can easily happen, guys? Okay, you can end up having air pockets in the engine block and the cylinder head. As a result, the car will overheat. It will develop bad head gasket, okay, and from there you start getting bubbles in the thing too. But one thing that can actually cause you to have air bubbles after you drain the coolant, okay, and you put coolant, you start driving, and if you notice bubbles, that means that you may still have air pockets inside the engine. That's why it's important to bleed the cooling system. If you want to see how to bleed the cooling system, the video will be on our channel, okay, and we'll have a video how to bleed the cooling system, so check it out. Hopefully the video will be helpful to any of you trying to find this information. Thank you for watching and see you next time.